Hi, welcome to the Vector Garden. Someone asked whether you can hide objects in Illustrator. And this question is really interesting depending on how you interpret it. And let's take a look at the different approaches of hiding objects in Illustrator. So the simple approach is you can select all of this and then go to Object Hide Selection or use the shortcut. And then the object is gone. So it's no longer there. Well, it is there, but it's hidden. This has some consequences. So you can no longer select it when selecting all. So let's go to select all and you see it doesn't get selected. If you have watched my previous videos, then you know, of course, you can select hidden objects. And this can also get slightly dangerous. So let's take a look at what happens when you move the artboard. So I'm going to not move it. I'm going to copy it by pressing Alt. And you see there are the objects and they get moved. So let's go into Outline View. There they aren't. So let's go to Object and show all, and you see they are there. That is a preference setting that you can move the hidden objects with the artboard. You find it in the Illustrator preferences. If you're on Windows, they are in Edit Preferences and Selection and Anchor Display, and there is this setting. So let's go to the next answer. So maybe you want to be still able to select it by just going like this. Then you can't just hide them, but you can do something else. So what you can do is set their opacity to 0, like so. They're gone, but you can select them like this. But, well, you don't know where they are. But this can be found out in Outline View, like so. So that's the second method you have. The next thing is, well, maybe you want to hide just these details. And you do not only want to hide them, but they should actually not be hidden, but subtracted from the background. So how do you go about that? These are grouped. Let's first ungroup them. I'm using the shortcut for that. And what you can then do is select all of this and then go to Window, Pathfinder, and just subtract them. Well, this is not really well editable. So if you want to edit those shapes, well, that's not possible. There are different methods to approach this. I'm going to undo this. What you can do is press this shape mode while holding down the Alt key, and then you create a compound shape, and that's editable. You can double click it, and then you can still select them and somewhat edit them. They are outline strokes, so editing will be kind of difficult. I'm going out of that. And let's go to undo that again, because there's another method. You can select them and deselect the drum. And let's first apply a different fill to that. Let's fill it in black. And then let's group all of them. Like so. So they are not yet grouped. Let's do that again. Select them and group them. So now they are grouped. And I'm going to group these shapes as well. And let's do this and bring them to the front. Select both of them and go to Window and then Transparency. And let's make a mask. Uncheck the clip option, and there we have the line work subtracted from the drum. And you see that what we had previously, all these outlines, are now gone as well. They just got subtracted. This is already slightly more difficult to achieve, so let's get to the next one. And the next one would be, well, I do not only want to hide them, well, I do want to hide it, but I only want to hide the white. So what I actually want is the background showing through where it is now white and the black line work should stay. So how would I go about that? And this is all grouped, so let's go into isolation mode. I'm going to double click it. So it's now isolated. I am only editing these shapes. And I'm going to take the direct selection tool, select this shape. They are still grouped. And let's go to select same fill color, like so. And then we can go to window appearance. And we only have the fill in here. This is what we wanted. I'm going to inside of it, and there's an opacity setting, and I'm going to set the opacity of the white fills to 0, like so. And then you can say, well, that's not what I wanted, because all the black lines are now showing through everything. That's not quite what I wanted. So let's first go out of isolation mode and then select the complete group. Go into the opacity setting and let's turn on knockout group, like so. And now you see this is what we wanted to have. And we didn't have to punch anything. This can be reverted and this can still be edited. So a simple question that led us to knockout groups, a quite advanced feature in Illustrator. But you see, it makes some complicated requests easy to achieve. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.